Alright, so we're starting with this chapter, Chemical Reactions and Equations. Now, first of all, let's just take an introduction of chemistry. Aapko in class 9th, when you started with chemistry, what have you done? Have you done the introduction what chemistry is? So, today I'll just take an introductory session over here. What do you understand by the term chemistry? You know what science is, isn't it? Science is anything to do with technology. That is what is a layman's language, we say that science is anything to do with technology. And science is broadly classified into three different branches. The first one, which is going to be biology, which is known as the living science, science of life, right? Second one, that is known as physics, which is actually the technical science in which we do all the kind of experimentations, or we build up buildings, or we have machines. So anything to do with machines, that is what you are going to study under physics. And then we have chemistry. Chemistry, that is that branch of science which studies matter. So anything to do with matter, jo bhi hum matter ke baare mein padhte hai, whether it is the composition, whether it is the reactions, whether how matter exists, right? Whether it is existing in the solid state, it is existing in the liquid state or in the gaseous state, all that we are going to study under chemistry. So basically chemistry, that is that branch of science which is going to study matter. Now in our day-to-day life, we have seen that there are many, many things. In fact, everything whatever we are using, that is pertaining to chemistry. Jaise for example, aap wood use kar rahe ho, plastics use kar rahe hain, polythene use kar rahe hain, nylon use kar rahe hain, right? Fabric hum jo apna use karte hain, this all that is chemistry. Apart from this, the medicines or the drugs which we have, right? Soaps, detergents, all the cleansing agents you can say, they all are going to come under chemistry. So chemistry, that is a very, very wide subject, and nowadays pharmaceuticals because we are talking of medicines over here, everything that is being studied under chemistry. Okay. Now in this particular chapter, when we are writing the topic as chemical reactions and equations, over here I'm just going to take an overview what all we are going to study in this chapter. We will study, you have already done symbols in your class 9. So we are going to study over here how those symbols or how whatever we are reacting together, the reactants which we are reacting and the products which we are getting, un sabko hum symbol form mein kis tarah se likhte hain. You've studied about physical changes and chemical changes in your last class. Theek hai? To hum physical changes ko, chemical changes ko kis tarah se classify karte hain, kis tarah se hum unko segregate karte hain, all that we are going to study in this chapter. And then in your class 9 you have done law of conservation of mass. Law of conservation of mass kya bolta hai ki agar we are reacting two reactants, right, then the total weight of the reactants, that will always be equal to the total weight of the products. So that is law of conservation of mass, the base on which the balancing of the chemical equations, that is going to be done in this particular chapter. Theek hai? And finally, depending upon ki reactants kis tarah se react kar rahe hai aur kya hume products mil rahe hai, we are also going to study the types of reactions in this chapter. So let's just take we are going to study in this chapter. So we are going to do it topic wise. Okay, so let's go on to the first topic over here. So when we are talking of the first topic, it is seen that we are going to first classify the changes. Reactions kya hote hai? Reactions, they are going to be changes. These changes, they may be classified into a physical change, theek hai? And the second one, which is a chemical change. You know that in physical change, the components, they can be recovered back by changing the temperature and pressure. Okay, jaise for example, agar hum ice ko melt kar rahe hain water mein at or to kya karenge, hum temperature ko increase karenge, but jab hum water ko wapas ice pe banana chahte hain to hum kya kar rahe hain, we are going to decrease the temperature. Theek hai? So that is what a physical change. As the composition of water is the same, whether we are taking water in the form of ice, or we are taking water in the form of liquid, or we are taking water in the form of gas, right? Whenever the composition that remains same, there is no change in composition, then that is going to be known as the physical change. So we're not going to go into detail of physical change as you've already done it in class 9. We will discuss more about a chemical change over here. So chemical change kya hua? Chemical change means that whenever the composition of the product that is going to be different than that of the reactant, that is going to be a chemical change. ठीक है, so जब हमने reactants को दोनों को add करा है और हमारे पास एक product बना है, वो जो product है उस product की कोई भी आप कह सकते हो characteristic reactant के साथ नहीं मिलती है, that is going to be a chemical change. So we can do many activities regarding this. Let's just go on to the first activity over here, first experiment which we can do. We can take two test tubes, right? Now in one of the test tube we are going to take over here liquid lead nitrate solution. So we are taking over here lead nitrate. You have to remember the formulae simultaneously because I will ask you in the next class. Okay, so we have taken liquid lead nitrate solution, and in the other one we have taken liquid potassium iodide solution. Okay, so we have taken two test tubes A and B. In one we have taken lead nitrate, and the other we have taken potassium iodide. Now we are going to mix these two solutions. Okay, now when we mix the two solutions, what do we observe? We observe that there is a yellow precipitate which is formed and settled at the bottom of the test tube. And this yellow precipitate, that is a precipitate of lead iodide. Right? So it means now what happens? आपने PbNO3 लिया, उसके characteristics अलग है. आपने potassium iodide लिया, उसके characteristics अलग है. ना ये yellow था, ना ये yellow था. पर जब हमने इन दोनों को mix किया तो हमारे पास yellow color का lead iodide solution आ गया. So it means that what kind of a change is taking place over here? It is going to be a chemical change. ठीक है? Similarly, let's take another example to explain the chemical change. In this case, in the second activity, what we are doing is that we are going to take a magnesium ribbon, right? Magnesium is a metal. उसका हम एक ribbon देते हैं और उसको पहले उसके ऊपर हमको clean करना पड़ेगा. So we clean it with a sandpaper. When we are cleaning it with a sandpaper, what is the purpose of cleaning it? So that there are no impurities which are present on the sand magnesium ribbon. ठीक है? There should be no impurities present. Then after that, what we are doing? We are taking a Bunsen burner. Right? So we are taking a Bunsen burner and we are burning that magnesium ribbon. When we are burning the magnesium ribbon, we are going to collect the ash over here. Okay? So ye jo ash hamare paas aati hai, this is going to be a black color ash which is formed due to burning of the magnesium ribbon. Now this is magnesium. We are burning it in presence of oxygen. Okay? So the black ash which we are getting over here, that is that of magnesium oxide. Got it? So now again, if you will see that when we are looking at the characteristics of magnesium, magnesium is not black in color. Oxygen is also not black in color, but the residue which we are getting over here, that is black in color. So there is going to be a change in composition, as a result of which what do we say? That there is a chemical change which has taken place over here. Okay? Let's go on to another activity, third activity which we are taking. In this case, again we are going to take a test tube. Okay? Is test tube ke andar humne sodium carbonate le liya hai. Right? Let's take sodium carbonate in this and we are pouring over here sulfuric acid, H2SO4, which is the sulfuric acid. Now when we put sulfuric acid over here, dilute sulfuric acid we are going to put, when we are putting sulfuric acid over here, suddenly we will see what, that there is going to be effervescence. right? Now it's the same as, you know, you have taken soda water, or soda water ke andar aap jab salt dalte to kya hota hai, ekdam se it comes out. That is the process of effervescence, right? So it means that when we put H2SO4, we have a phenomenon of effervescence which is taking place. This effervescence, this effervescence is due to liberation of carbon dioxide. Okay, now because this carbon dioxide that is coming out, it will have no properties similar to H2SO4 and Na2CO3. Okay, so dono ke saath koi bhi property uski nahi mil rahi hai. It means that it is going to be a chemical change over here. Have you understood? Then the last activity which is going to explain or which is going to illustrate a chemical change. In this case, we have taken a conical flask. Is tarah se, right? Now we've taken a conical flask. In this conical flask, we have taken granules of zinc. Right? We have taken granules of zinc. And from here we are, इसको हमने cork के साथ बंद कर दिया है, यहाँ से हमने एक stirrer डाला, and we have also put inside this dilute H2SO4 sulfuric acid. Now when we put dilute sulfuric acid and we are shaking it, or we are stirring it with the help of a stirrer, we will see there are certain bubbles of a gas which are being evolved. ठीक है? अब ये जो bubbles of a gas है, जब experimentally हम लोग इसको देखते हैं, investigate करते हैं, collect करते हैं, तो ये जो bubbles of a gas है, जैसे ही हम इसके पास एक burning splinter लाएंगे, it is going to burn with a pop. It gives a popping sound. So that is a test for hydrogen. It means that this gas which is eliminated over here, that is going to be what? It is going to be hydrogen. Again, hydrogen will have no similarity with H2SO4 and zinc, thereby telling us that when we are mixing dilute H2SO4 with zinc, there is going to be a chemical change which is taking place. Okay? So this is all what you need to know about a chemical change. Let's move on to the characteristics of a chemical change. Talking of characteristics of a chemical change, it is seen that a chemical change that can be seen by, number one, change in state. So you've already seen in all these activities, in some of them we were reacting a solid with a liquid and a gas was evolved. In certain cases, we were reacting two different solids, or a gas and a solid was evolved. So generally, a chemical change that is going to occur by change of state. Okay? Then secondly, it may be accompanied by change of color. Okay? So there is going to be a change of color whenever a chemical change is taking place. Then thirdly, it may be accompanied by evolution of a gas. As you saw that when you were reacting zinc with H2SO4, hydrogen gas that was evolved. So it may be accompanied by evolution of a gas, or it may also be accompanied by either absorption or evolution of heat. Okay? So either absorption of heat may take place. Absorption of heat means what? When you are mixing two things, you will see that the tumbler that becomes cold. So in that case, there is absorption of heat which is taking place. And sometimes the tumbler that becomes hot, that is evolution of heat is taking place. We will discuss about these reactions in the later sections, right? Then we come to, after looking at the chemical changes which are taking place, let's understand what a chemical equation means, right? So now by this we come to the main part of your chapter. What is a chemical equation? Now whenever we are talking of any chemical change, a chemical equation, that is a statement which is going to represent a chemical reaction. So chemical change is a statement
which represents a chemical reaction. Okay? So anything which is, any statement which is going to represent a chemical reaction, that is going to be a chemical change. For example, from the activities which we had done, if we are taking lead nitrate plus potassium iodide, that is going to give us lead iodide plus potassium nitrate. Okay? So this is what a chemical equation that is going to be. Now you can see in this chemical reaction that there is a left hand side and there is a right hand side. Okay? Or which way there is going to be an arrow. What are all these things going to indicate? Anything which is going to react together and which is placed at the left hand side of a chemical reaction, that they are going to be known as reactants. And anything which after reaction is going to be formed and which is placed at the right hand side of the reaction, they are said to be products. Okay, so over here you can see that this arrow means whenever you see an arrow to see the direction whenever you're going out. So jab arrow dekhte ho to see the direction, what does that indicate? It indicates that the passage or the direction you have to walk is given by the arrow in that direction where the exact location of the place is going to be. So over here also we are going from the direction of the reactants to the direction of the products. Therefore the arrow that is going to be placed in this manner. Okay, so this is what your left hand side or right hand side that is going to indicate in the chemical equation. Now in this case you can see that we are writing, we are not writing the formula, but we are only writing the words for a chemical equation. So this is known as word equation. Although this is a very, you know, easy method to give the formulation of any reaction, right? बहुत easy है, इससे आपको formula नहीं learn करने, कुछ नहीं learn करना, valencies learn करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. So simply you just write it in the word form and you're done with. But this is a very long procedure, right? Long मतलब you can see that it is taking so much of your paper, it is utilizing so much of my chalk and it is also taking a lot of time, isn't it? So उसको हमें cut short करना है. As humans, we always need shortcuts. So to bring this reaction to a shorter value, instead of using word equations, we are going to use over here simple equations. Now in order to do the simple equations, the first thing which you need to do is, you need to know the symbols. If you don't know the symbols, you will not be able to do the symbol equations. So before going on to symbol equations, we are going to do symbols and valencies of some of the elements. Okay? So let's just take a chart over here. We are going to take the name of the element. Right? We are going to take symbol. This you should memorize by heart because otherwise you cannot understand chemistry at all. Right? And first of all, let's just take the name and the symbol and then we will talk of valency later. So let's go on to the first one, aluminium, right? Aluminium that is going to have the symbol Al. You've done in your class 9 how do you take the symbols. Either it is the first two letters of the word or if it is Greek words, then you are going to take it with the help of its pronunciation, right? So over here, aluminium when we are taking off, we are simply taking the first two letters of the word aluminium, right? Similarly, the next one which we are going to do is argon. So again, what is going to be the symbol over here? Ar. So these are easily memorizable. You can easily remember them when we are only taking the first state. Another one, barrier. Again, we are taking the first two letters only. So, simple, easy to memorize, barrier, right? Then we go to borone. In case of borone, we only take the first letter. So, what is going to be the symbol over here? B. Okay? Next, we go to calcium. Again, the first two letters. So, what is going to be the symbol over here? Ca. And then if we are taking carbon, only the first letter, C. Now, over here, both you can say that this is also Ca, this is also Ca. In case of calcium, we are going to consider the first two letters. But in case of carbon, we are only going to consider the first letter. Okay? Which is C. Then we have chlorine. Now, chlorine cannot be written as CH. Okay? Over here, we are going to take the first and the third letter. So, the symbol over here, that is going to be Cl. Chlorine. Okay? Fir uske baad aa gaya hamare paas cobalt, CO. Right? Cobalt ke baad we have copper. Now, in case of copper, we are not going to take it the normal word. We are going to take its Latin word, which is cuprous or which is cupric. Okay? So, yahan pe hum kya lenge? Depending upon that, two elements cannot have the same symbols. So, over here, copper, we are going to take it as Cu. Theek hai? Clear ho gaya? Fir uske baad hamare paas aa jata hai fluorine. The first letter, which is F. Fluorine, that is going to be taken as F. Then we come to gold. Gold ka jo word hai, that is aurum. So, from aurum, we are getting over here Au. Okay, fir uske baad gold ke baad we have hydrogen. H, helium, He, ठीक है? फिर helium के बाद हमारे पास आता है the next one which we are going to do is iodine. I, then iron. Now again iron cannot be taken as IR, so it comes from the Greek word ferrum or ferrous or ferric. So, we are going to take the first two letters, right? Fe. Clear ho gaya? Fir uske baad hamare paas aa jata hai lead. Pb from plumpus. So, that is how we are getting lead as Pb. Then we have magnesium. Which is going to be Mg. After magnesium, we have manganese. Which is taken as Mn. Right? Manganese ke baad we have neon. Ne. Nitrogen. N. Right? Nitrogen is a gas. N. Then we come to nickel. Ni. Oxygen, which has a symbol O. After oxygen, we have platinum. Pt. Potassium. K. Right? Potassium that has the symbol K. Then let's go on to silicon. Si. Silver. Ag. Okay? Or silver ke baad we come to sodium. So we're doing this alphabetically, so it's easier for you to remember. Right? Sodium, that is going to be Na. Okay? After sodium, we have sulfur, S, then tin. Tin has the word stannous, right? So So that is why TIM comes from that. The symbol comes from stannous, which is SN. Okay? And then uske baad aa jata hai zinc. Which is going to be ZN. So these are a few symbols which will be used regularly when we are going to do the chemical equations. Then there are many. There are 118 elements which you are going to study in your periodic table. And out of those 118 elements, 112 have been given symbols. Rest of them, they have not yet been given any appropriate symbols. So in your class 10, we are only going to restrict our study to certain amount of, you cannot learn the symbols of all of them, all 112 elements. So whichever are going to be frequently used in your syllabus, we are only going to learn that as of now. Okay? Otherwise, when you go to class 11 and 12, and if you take sciences, you can learn the rest of them. Alright? So let's now go on to it. Whenever we are making a chemical formula, it will not only depend upon the symbols, it will also depend upon the valency. You have done in class 9 what valency is. Valency, that is going to be what? It is the combining capacity. Right? How much electrons can any element part with in order to make a compound? Okay? It's just like two friends who want to share their sweets. Okay? Now, if one has only two, he will only be able to give two. If the other one has five, he will only be able to give five. So, by exchanging sweets, what they are doing, they are becoming friends. Alright, so that is what the combining capacity of any element is going to be, and that combining capacity, that is going to be known as what? Valency. Now over here with the elements, instead of course elements do not have sweets, so what are they going to have? They are going to have electrons. Okay, they are going to part away with their electrons. So agar wo electrons de rahe hai, to wo kya hai? Positively charged. Agar wo electrons le rahe hai, to wo kya hai? Negatively charged. Right? You know what electron is, na? Electron is a negatively charged particle which is present in any atom. So, agar electrons kam ho jayenge, electrons kam kab hote hai? Jab wo apne electrons de deta hai. Agar electrons kam ho jayenge, to uske upar electrons negative charge kam ho jayega. Therefore, it is going to get a positive charge. Okay? Aur agar wo electrons accept kar rahe hai, to uske paas negative charge zyada ho jayega. Therefore, that is going to be negative charge, and that is what valency is. So, we are going to study a small chart of valency over here, which you need to remember. Alright, so let's go on to, as I said, any element can have positive charge. Jitne wo electrons deta hai, utna hi positive charge uske upar ho jata hai. If it is giving one electron, so one positive charge. If it is giving two electrons, then two positive charge. If it is giving three electrons, then three positive charge. And if it is giving 4 electrons, then it is going to be 4 positive charge, which is very, very rare. So we have plus 1, plus 2, plus 3 and plus 4. In a similar manner, jitne electrons wo accept karega, uske basis pe uske upar negative charge aa jayega. If it is accepting 1, it is going to have 1 negative charge. If it is accepting 2, it is going to have 2 negative charge. And if it is accepting 3, it is going to have 3 negative charge. Similarly, whenever we are talking of ye jo species bante hai by gaining electrons or by losing electrons, they are going to be known as ions. Right? Because atom as a whole is going to be neutral. It does not have any charge. It only acquires charge by either giving away the electrons or accepting the electrons. Right? So, these ions, they are going to be the base of any formula. Okay, so let's see over here, all those, first of all, we are taking over here positively charged ions. All those elements which have a tendency to lose electrons, they are going to form positive ions, as I have just told you. Okay, so over here, we have those with plus 1, right? So plus 1 ke saath hamare paas kya hai? You already know the symbol, so I am not going to write down the full this thing. This is H positive, right? Then we have Na positive, we have K positive, then we have Cu positive, right? And then we are going to have Ag positive. So these which have one positive charge, they are known as unipositive ions. Uni means one. Okay? So all of these, they are going to be unipositive ions. Then we have all those which are going to have plus 2 charge. So plus 2 charge, we have Cu2 positive, we have Ba2 positive, okay? Uske baad we have Ca2 positive, we have mercury, this is Hg, this is known as mercury. Mercury can have both. As you can see, copper can also have both, plus 1 and plus 2 both, okay? In a similar manner, mercurius. Also remember, jaise hum log copper ki do ye kar rahe hai, when you will write out the word names for the compounds which are formed from this. Jab hum copper ki dekh rahe hai, to copper has unipositive charge also and it has bipositive charge also. Jab unipositive charge hota hai, then we use the word us. Okay, so this iron that is going to be known as cuprous iron. Always the smaller charge that is going to have us and the bigger charge that is going to have ik. Right? So Cu positive kya ho jayega? Cuprous. Or Cu2 positive kya ho jayega? Cupric. Is it clear? In a similar manner, when we have over here Hg, Hg is mercury. So ye chota hai na, one positive charge, this is mercurous and this is going to be mercuric. The larger one is always ik and the smaller one that is going to be always us. And this only happens in those ions which are going to have variable valencies. Isko variable bolte hai na, iske paas one positive bhi show karte hai, two positive bhi show karte hai, so this is going to be what? Variable valency. Theek hai? Let's move on to some other. Cobalt, nickel, ठीक है? फिर उसके बाद iron. Again देखो, iron is Fe2 positive and you know that iron is Fe3 positive also. So this is going to be ferrous, right? और 3 positive वाला क्या हो जाएगा? Ferric. Okay. So this is ferrous. Then you have Mg2 positive. Mg2 positive के बाद we have Mn2 positive, manganese. Zinc 2 positive. All these they are going to have 2 positive valencies and then also we have Pb2 positive. Right? Is it clear? Again, iski bhi aap dekhoge variable valency rahegi. So this is Plumbus. Lead hai na ye? Lead ko hum log Plumbus se dekhte hai. So this is the smaller valency. This is going to be Plumbus. Then let's go on to all those elements which show plus 3 charge. The first one which we have over here, that is going to be Al3 positive, aluminium, right? Then we have ferric, Fe3 positive. So this is what we were doing over here, this is ferrous and this is going to be what? It is going to be ferric. Okay? Fir uske baad we have chromium. Chromium also has Cr3 positive. And then we have bismuth. Bismuth also has Bi3 positive. Then we go on to all those which have plus 4 charge. Right? So plus 4 charge may we have plumbic. As I said that rarely they exist in positive. So this is plumbic. Plumbus kaun sa tha? Pb2 positive. Not Pb3 positive. Plumbus is Pb2 positive and plumbic that is going to be Pb4 positive. Okay? And then we have platinum. Platinum is also going to have 4 positive charge. Okay? Right? Now all these, they all have only one kind of atoms. So these all are said to be monoatomic in nature. Mono means one. Okay? So monoatomic. Then we go on to certain monoatomic negatively charged ions. So let's go on to minus 1. Minus 1 charge kiska hota hai? Fluoride, chloride, bromide, iodide, hydride, right? All these they are going to have one negative charge. Fir uske baad minus 2 charge kiska hoga? Oxide. ठीक है, sorry, minus 2 charge किसका होगा? Oxide and sulfide. IDE. When it is IDE, it is going to be monoatomic. So this is sulfide. This is where you get confused. Okay. So IDE क्या होगा? Sulfide. That is going to be S2 negative monoatomic. Only one kind of atom which is present. Then we have in a similar manner minus 3, N3 negative. So monoatomic, again the suffix IDE is going to come. So this is nitride. Okay? And then we have P3 negative, which is phosphide. Have you understood? So ab ye sare hamare paas monoatomic ions hai. Let's go on to certain polyatomic ions. Poly means more than one. So all these ions, they are going to contain more than one atom. Okay? Polyatomic. So when we're talking of polyatomic, let's talk of polyatomic which has one positive charge. An example which we can take over here is ammonium ion. NH4 positive. Kitne atoms hai iske paas? 4 plus 1? 5. So that is how it is known as polyatomic. This is one of the most common type of this thing you have to remember in your 10th. Polyatomic, unipositive ion. Okay? Uske baad let's go on to minus 1. Hydroxide. OH negative. Okay? Phir uske baad, this is, okay, I'll write this for you over here. Hydroxide. Then we have HCO3 negative. This is going to be known as bicarbonate. ठीक है? फिर उसके बाद हमारे पास आता है now C. NO3 negative. Polyatomic है और जब O3 negative होगा, then it is the suffix uses 8. So this is going to be known as nitrate. ठीक है? फिर उसके बाद हमारे पास नाइट्रेट के बाद आ जाता है, चलो इतना ही करो आप, एसीटेट आयन करने की जरूरत नहीं हमें. Then let's go on to all those which have minus 2 charge. The first one which we are going to do over here is carbonate. 8 हम तब join करते हैं if oxygen is present. तो आप यहाँ पे देखो oxygen is present at the end, not over here because यहाँ पे prefix है ना oxygen, यहाँ पे suffix है oxygen. So 8 we are using. Similarly, यहाँ पे 8 we are using, there also 8 we are using, carbonate, ठीक है? फिर उसके बाद आपके पास आता है sulfide. Now, what is the difference between ide and ide? Ide is going to be monoatomic, ide is going to be triatomic, polyatomic. So, SO3 negative, this is going to be sulfide. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद नेक्स्ट हमारे पास आता है सल्फाइड के बाद सल्फेट. SO4 2 negative. These are a few confusing ones. Sulfide, sulfide and sulfate. Right? SO4 2 negative, that is going to be sulfate. Then we have minus 3 charge. Minus 3 charge polyatomic mein kiske paas present hai? Phosphate. Phosphate is PO4 3 negative. Right? This is going to be phosphate. Phir uske baad humare paas aa jata hai phosphide. Jiske paas zyada oxygen atoms wo A, jiske paas kam oxygen atoms wo I. Yahan pe bhi aap dekho nitrite bhi aap de sakte ho. Nitrite is going to be over here, it is going to be 3 negative. Okay? This is phosphite, right? And then we have over here borate. Borate is going to be what? BO3 3 negative. So these are the valencies which you need to remember in order to form the formulae. So for tomorrow, what you have to do? Learn all these valencies. dependencies. So that we can just take a recap of how do you make the formula from the valencies as you have done it in class 9, and then we go on to the main chapter. Okay?